So good afternoon one and all. I'm in this session I'm talking on lifestyle and behavior modification polycystic ovarian syndrome, a NEST approach. This approach is based on international guideline of polycystic ovarian syndrome 2018. So as we know, insulin resistance and compensatory hyperinsulinemia, they are known key component of this syndrome, and insulin resistance underlines much of the pathophysiology of polycystic ovarian syndrome. As we don't know exact cause of polycystic ovarian syndrome, but poor diet, insulin resistance and chronic stress, they are current hypothesis. As per Cochrane review, lifestyle intervention, they improve androgen free androgen index, weight and BMI in women. Also, international evidence-based guideline 2018, they have clearly said that lifestyle intervention can reduce weight, central obesity, insulin resistance, and optimize your quality of life. So what is this NEST approach? NEST stands for nutrition, exercise, stress, and treatment, that is sensible supplementation. But contrary to all guidelines, where they all state that 5 to 10% weight reduction will help you, PCOS NEST approach emphasizes on increasing your lean body mass, that is skeletal muscle mass. Muscle is only metabolically active tissue in your body. It will increase your metabolism, burn your fat, normalize your hormones. So as per guideline, there should be negative energy balance of approximately 30%, that is 500 to 700 calorie. And the key components are low glycemic index diet, complex carbohydrate diet, and carbohydrate distribution diet. So what is this low GI diet? GI stands for glycemic index of a food. It is a ranking of food based on how quickly it will raise your blood sugar after you eat it. So low GI food, they will increase your blood sugar immediately. The peak will be high, the dip will be very low. So we have, how to distribute these what are types of carbohydrate? There are simple carbohydrate like sugar, candies. They will be broken in very refined tiny glucose particle after eating, and immediately they enter bloodstream, and immediately they will raise your blood sugar, so that there will be increased insulin requirement. Our goal is complex carbohydrate rule. These are also sugar, but they are coated by fibers. They are released very slow. The peak will be not so much so high, and the dip also will not be very low. We can go one step ahead and have low GI diet. This GL stands for glycemic load. It means glycemic index plus amount of that carbohydrate. So how to measure that amount? There are portion size, serving size. Serving size is this is way of breaking down food into portion that will provide approximately 12 to 15 grams of carbohydrate per portion. So we have to learn how to measure this portion. There are various guide. We have come up with some portion guide. We use atoms, or we can use our fist to calculate a portion of. So if we have to eat rice, then we can eat that particular food of size of tennis ball or palm full of that cooked rice. This is the next important aspect is we have to distribute our diet. Why to distribute diet? We have to distribute in 3 smaller meals and 2 snacks per day. Why to distribute? Because very less insulin will be needed over next few hours to sweep that sugar out of the bloodstream, and transition from 3 major meals to more spread 3 meals to 2 snacks, we will be ahead of our hunger, which lead to ultimately eating less. So how to distribute diet? If our goal is to have 1600 calories, that will come up to 180 gram of carbohydrate a day. So we have to distribute, if we are going according to 2 major meal theory by Dikshit sir, this is not going to help, because very large bolus of glucose will enter into blood. So it is intelligent to distribute it in either 3 major meal or 3 meals and 2 snacks. So there will be less sugar entering your bloodstream. So another way of looking at this is to rate your hunger on the scale of 1 to 10. 1 is not hungry, 10 is starved. And you have to eat when your hunger is at the level of 6, that is somewhat angry. So instead of waiting till starved, so avoiding extreme hunger will help you slow down your eating and control overeating. You can there is another approach to do this by doing balanced plate approach, where we divide our plate in three part. Half of the part is covered with non-starchy vegetable like cabbage, cauliflower. So they will we are eating very low calorie, high fiber food. They will take most of the space in your stomach. So there it will contribute to biological process of feeling full. 25% will be lean protein and the rest 25% will be high quality starch like jawar, root vegetable, rice and fruit. But here we have to observe portion size. So summary of diet guidelines are low GI diet, carb distributed diet, and you have to observe your portion size. And very quickly, exercise guidelines, we have to do at least 150 minutes of moderate intensity aerobic activity or 75 minutes of vigorous intensity aerobic activity per week. And along with that, we have to do strength exercise two times on non-consecutive day. Why strength exercise required? Because every exercise is limited by design and cannot look to different component of fitness, which are endurance, strength, flexibility and cardiorespiratory balance. Like running can improve your stamina and endurance, but it has nothing to do with your flexibility and strength. So this aerobic exercise is doing moderate to high intensity activity for more than 30 minutes. Aerobic activity will increase your endurance. It will increase your cardiorespiratory fitness. The next approach is interval exercise, where we do this endurance activity in alternate slow pace and high pace, that is low intensity and moderate to high intensity, so that time required will be less and the benefit gain will be more. So PCOS Nest has come up with this very simple, realistic, middle class married woman can do at home without any assistance. These are the basic exercise where all core body muscles are they are covered. Basic crunches, side planks, lunges and bridges. These are exercise, they are very helpful. These are basic core body workouts. Muscle strengthening exercise has to be done on non-consecutive day, two times a week. Why muscle strengthening exercise is so important? Because muscle is only metabolically active tissue in the body. Muscle increases your metabolism and burn your fat. And losing muscle is aging. And another very important aspect is muscle strengthening exercise is blessed with afterburn. After every exercise, there is a burning of calorie for 3 to 4 hours. After aerobic exercise, it is only for 4 to 5 hours. But after muscle strengthening exercise, this afterburn is up to 48 hours. So that is why we don't have to do it on non-consecutive days. So this is why muscle strengthening exercise is, and most of the patients suffering from polycystic ovarian, they are doing endless cardio exercise, endless 2 hours running, 2 hours walking. That is not going to help you if you are not doing muscle strengthening exercise. So PCOS Nest has come up with some muscle strengthening exercise, which I was cover major muscle group of your body. We have to buy two dumbbells, 2 kg or 5 kg dumbbell pair, and you can do this at home without within 10 or 15 minutes. And the last and very important aspect is how to manage stress. Stress management is a very important issue in this polycystic ovarian syndrome patients. There are various way of doing stress management. As before that, madam had talked very well on yoga, meditation. There are few mindfulness exercise, breathing exercise. There is no time on talk on this exercise right now. Schedule relaxation, mindfulness, meditation and yoga. But this CBT, cognitive behavior therapy, this is gaining very good pace in Western countries. So what is this? And this is very helpful in polycystic ovarian syndrome patient. So what is this cognitive behavior therapy? So we have got this hot cross burn model of CBT formulation here. It says that your thought and your feeling, they influence your behavior. This is based on the concept that thought, feeling and physical sensation, they are interconnected. And if we have thought, suppose someone was passing, she did not look at us, we feel that she is avoiding us. That is her feeling. And this feeling, why feeling? Because she thinks that I am obese, I have hirsutism, she is avoiding me. This is her feeling. So she is doing a behavior, a faulty behavior. She is avoiding people. She is resting at home, not going out, not doing exercise. So this is her faulty behavior. And this is giving to her physical sensation like headache, gastritis. So this is our cognitive behavior therapy. It addresses this. There are various way of doing this cognitive behavior counseling of the patient. Very important three concept I'll talk and then I'll stop. Rational emotive behavior therapy, cognitive therapy and behavior therapy. This rational emotive behavior theory, this is very famous in India, where we have to identify irrational belief. We are identifying that faulty belief, we are addressing that belief, we are taking say 10 to 20 sessions, we are finding that belief and we are trying to change that belief. That's it. But after that, cognitive therapy, the proper cognitive, the solo is that we have to change that cognition, that thinking we have to change. So we have to sit with that patient, we have to take some sessions. We find and identify and change that distorting thinking pattern. We have to find that pattern, we have to change that pattern. So cognitive therapy is examining thought and it is basically discussion based. And the last approach is behavior therapy. So behavior therapy means whatever we have find out, we have to go out in the world and actually test that behavior. So we have to arrange some people, we have to arrange some friends and ask her to go with that lady because she is not going out of her room. So and then she start behaving and her distress, her stress, her emotion, they are very controlled. There are various way of doing this behavior therapy. I'll end my session with this very famous thought of Thomas Edison, doctor of future, they will no longer treat human with drugs, but rather they will cure and prevent disease with the nutrition. Thank you.